Welcome to our Mystery Sleep Stories channel, your sanctuary for meditation and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this quest for deep sleep. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our mystery bedtime stories. So, let the tale begin. The Enigma of the Venetian Masks. Chapter 1. The Discovery. In the narrow, winding streets of Venice, where the gentle lapping of canal waters plays a ceaseless serenade, Luca, a young and passionate mask maker, had set up his humble workshop. Known for his exquisite craftsmanship, Luca's masks were coveted across the city for their beauty and intricacy. Yet, his life was about to take a turn towards the extraordinary, far beyond the confines of leather and paint. It was on a cool, damp morning when the discovery happened. Luca was renovating a part of his workshop, which was an old, time-worn building inherited from his grandfather, a master mask maker himself. The wooden floorboards, swollen from time and moisture, creaked under his weight as he moved about. In a corner of the room, under a particularly decrepit board, Luca noticed a slight give. Curious, he pried it up, revealing a small, hidden cavity beneath. Inside this hidden nook lay a dust-covered, leather-bound journal. It was old, the leather cracked, and pages yellowed with age, but still intact. Luca opened it with reverent hands, his heart beating with the thrill of discovery. The journal was filled with meticulous handwriting, diagrams, and sketches of masks that Luca had never seen before. Masks that seemed to swirl with an almost tangible energy, even on paper. The journal belonged to a Venetian noble, who, according to a faded entry, had traveled extensively, collecting unique masks with rumored mystical attributes. This noble had been obsessed with the power of masks, believing them to be conduits of human emotion and gateways to understanding deeper truths about the human psyche. The journal spoke of a special collection of masks that possessed powers beyond the understanding of ordinary men. Masks that could reveal the hidden, bring truth to light, and even manipulate emotions. One mask in particular caught Luca's attention, a mask crafted from silver, with delicate filigree that seemed to mimic the flow of water. According to the journal, this mask allowed the wearer to see the true nature of those around them, unmasking lies and deceit. It was said to be hidden somewhere in Venice, protected by a series of cryptic clues left by the mask's last known owner. Intrigued and excited by the prospect of such an adventure, Luca decided to follow the clues laid out in the journal. Each entry was a riddle wrapped in layers of history and secrecy, leading him to explore Venice in ways he never had before. The first clue hinted at the reflection where the Doge once walked. Luca knew immediately this referred to the Hall of Mirrors in the Doge's palace, a place steeped in history and laden with hundreds of years of footsteps. As Luca prepared for his journey, he felt a surge of anticipation. The city he thought he knew so well was about to open up its hidden depths to him. With the ancient journal as his guide, he set out to unravel the mysteries it contained. His days of solitude and simple mask making seemed to be over. Ahead lay a path filled with discovery and danger, leading him deep into the heart of Venice's forgotten secrets. This journey would take him through the winding canals, beneath moonlit bridges, and into the shadows of the grand palaces where the past lingered and whispered. Each step would bring him closer to uncovering the reality of the mask's powers, and perhaps closer to understanding his own heritage and the legacy of his grandfather, who may have known more about these masks than Luca had ever imagined. As he locked up his workshop, journal in hand, the city seemed to whisper to him, its secrets ready to be discovered. The masks awaited, their stories etched in mystery and magic, hidden within the very fabric of Venice. Chapter 2, The Canal's Whisper. The next morning, with the early light casting a soft glow over the ancient stones of Venice, Luca set out in his gondola, the journal's leather-bound cover worn smooth by the touch of many hands. As he paddled through the waterways, the city began to wake, bridges and balconies adorned with the fluttering clothes drying in the morning sun, and the calls of merchants starting to fill the air. Luca's journey first led him towards the Rialto Market, a vibrant hub of commerce where the air was thick with the aroma of fresh seafood and spices. It was there, amongst the chaos of bartering voices and clattering footsteps, that Luca hoped to find the first clue referenced in the journal. According to the ancient text, the original owner of the silver mask often met clandestine contacts under the cover of market noise to discuss the secretive trade of mystical artifacts. As he navigated his gondola under the Rialto Bridge, Luca's eyes were drawn to the worn stones of the archway. There, almost hidden by the shadows, he spotted the crest mentioned in the journal, a subtle engraving of a masked face surrounded by waves, a symbol of the mask's reputed power to reveal truths hidden as deep as the sea. The discovery sent a thrill through him. The legends were rooted in reality. Further investigation around the area led Luca to a forgotten pier, tucked away behind a row of bustling shops. Here, the water lapped gently at the wood, each wave whispering secrets of the past. The pier's ancient stones were covered in moss and lichen, but upon closer inspection, Luca found more etchings, similar to those in the journal. They were part of a puzzle that, when viewed from a certain angle in the shifting light of day, revealed a map pointing towards an old merchant's villa along the Grand Canal. The villa, now decrepit and nearly swallowed by the encroaching dampness of the canal, was rumored to have been owned by a Venetian noble deeply involved in the occult. Luca approached with caution, the wooden shutters of the villa banging against the walls as the wind picked up, casting eerie shadows across his path. Inside, the air was musty with the smell of old books and rotting wood. The once lavish home was now a labyrinth of rooms and hallways filled with the remnants of a long-faded glory. In what appeared to be a study, Luca discovered a heavy wooden desk covered in dust. Drawers filled with old maps and documents hinted at the villa's past importance in Venice's mysterious underbelly. Among these papers, Luca found references to the custodians of the mask, a secret society that had guarded the powers of the masks for centuries. Their goal was to keep the masks safe from those who would use their powers for personal gain, preserving the balance of unseen forces within Venice. It became clear to Luca that his quest was more dangerous than he had anticipated. These custodians would not appreciate his prying into their secrets. the shadows lengthening and a feeling of being watched creeping upon him. Luca realized he needed to be more cautious. He took several of the documents, careful to leave little trace of his visit, and exited the villa just as the sun set, casting the canal in a golden light that seemed to both illuminate and deepen the surrounding shadows. As Luca paddled away from the villa, his mind raced with the implications of his discoveries. The masks, the secret society, and the cryptic clues all pointed to a deep and intricate history interwoven with the very foundation of Venice. Each stroke of his oar through the water felt like a step deeper into a world of hidden intrigues and powerful legacies. He knew he had to remain vigilant, for the waters of Venice were deep and full of currents that could easily pull an unwary traveler under. Chapter 3, Shadows of the Doge's Palace. Guided by the enigmatic clues and old documents discovered in the derelict villa, Luca's next destination was the majestic Doge's Palace, a structure that breathed the history and grandeur of Venice. Its ornate facades and imposing spires had witnessed the rise and fall of countless doges, and it was rumored that the palace itself was a labyrinth of secrets. The palace, standing regally by the lagoon, was open to the populace during the day. Tourists thronged its gilded halls, marveling at the opulent art and architecture that symbolized Venice's golden age. But Luca, with a purpose sharper than mere sightseeing, moved with a quiet intensity through the crowds. He sought the lesser-known parts of the palace, the areas not listed in travelers' guides, where the shadows spoke of forgotten tales and hidden doors. Using a discreet side entrance referenced in one of the old documents, a passage used by servants and lesser officials in days long past, Luca found himself in a part of the palace that felt entirely different. Here, the air was cooler, the silence more profound, interrupted only by the echo of his footsteps on the ancient stone floors. The lavish decorations of the public areas gave way to the stark, functional designs of the private quarters and administrative offices, where the real business of the palace had once been conducted. His research had hinted at a secret archive buried deep within these less traveled corridors, a repository of documents and artifacts related to the masked rituals once held by the doges to curry favor with mysterious forces. Navigating through a maze of corridors, Luca eventually came upon an old wooden door, its surface carved with the symbol of the silver mask, the same one he'd seen etched into the stone at the Rialto. With a cautious push, the door creaked open, revealing a dusty room filled with piles of old scrolls, ledgers, and manuscripts. The air smelled of parchment and wax, and as Luca stepped inside, a sense of stepping back in time enveloped him. Here were the records of Venice's secret dealings, the truths behind the facade of the Republic's opulence and power. Luca spent hours poring over the documents, each one peeling back layers of history, revealing the involvement of the Doge's office in the collection and concealment of the powerful masks. Notably, a series of letters detailed meetings between the Doges and a mysterious figure, referred to only as the Guardian, believed to be the leader of the custodians of the mask. These meetings discussed the political and social ramifications of the mask's powers, hinting at their use in controlling outcomes of significant political turmoil. As dusk began to fall, casting long shadows across the ornate ceiling of the archive room, Luca came across a particularly intriguing document. It was a faded map of the palace, annotated with a cryptic note. Under the moon, the silver light reveals the path to the golden mask. The map highlighted a secluded courtyard within the palace grounds, known for its alignment with the moon during certain times of the year. Realizing the importance of this clue, Luca carefully folded the map and tucked it into his jacket. He knew that tonight, if the lunar calendar he had studied was correct, the moon would shine directly over this courtyard, possibly revealing hidden mechanisms or pathways related to the Golden Mask's location. As he made his way out of the archive, the dim corridors of the Doge's palace seemed alive with the whispers of the past, each shadow and flicker of torchlight a reminder of the secrets the building held. Luca felt a growing connection to the history of his city, a tapestry of ambition, intrigue, and mysticism that was now his to unravel. Tonight's endeavor at the courtyard would be a significant step in unlocking the legacy of the masks, and perhaps securing his place in the annals of Venetian lore. Chapter 4, The Masquerade Unveiled. With the old map safely tucked into his jacket and the moon just beginning to climb in the evening sky, Luca made his way toward the secluded courtyard, highlighted as a key location in the Doge's palace. According to the ancient documents, this courtyard, rarely frequented by the day's crowds, played a central role in the lunar ceremonies once held by the secretive society of the custodians of the mask. As Luca approached, the sounds of the bustling city faded into a muted whisper, replaced by the soft gurgle of a hidden fountain, and the rustle of leaves stirred by a gentle breeze. The courtyard was an architectural marvel, framed by towering marble columns and ornate stone-carved arches that captured the moonlight, casting intricate shadows on the cobblestone floor. Luca walked slowly across the courtyard, his eyes scanning the surroundings for any signs or mechanisms that might be revealed by the moonlight. The air was thick with anticipation, and every shadow seemed to hold a secret. The map had indicated a specific spot, marked by an ancient sundial, now partially obscured by overgrown ivy. As the moon reached its zenith, its silver light aligned perfectly with the sundial, casting a long shadow that pointed directly to a loose stone in the wall. With a mixture of excitement and apprehension, Luca pressed against the stone, which moved slightly under his touch, revealing a narrow, winding staircase descending into the darkness below. Taking a deep breath, Luca descended the stairs, the air growing cooler with each step. The staircase led to a hidden underground chamber, untouched by time. The walls lined with masks of all shapes and sizes, each more elaborate than the last. In the center of the chamber stood a pedestal, upon which lay the golden mask, the object of Luca's long quest. It was even more magnificent up close, crafted from fine gold and inlaid with precious stones that shimmered in the light of the torches that Luca had lit along the walls. The mask's eyes seemed almost alive, a testament to the skill and mystical knowledge of its creator. Slowly reaching out to touch the mask, Luca felt a mixture of excitement and terror in his heart. The room appeared to come alive as his fingers touched the cool metal, the masks on the walls glowing brightly, as if they were calling attention to him. Luca experienced a surge of excitement as memories of earlier rituals appeared before him. He saw images of people dancing in masks beneath the moon, their motions both lovely and menacing. Realizing the power that he now held, Luca carefully lifted the golden mask from its resting place. He knew that possessing such an artifact came with great responsibility, and that the secretive society would not lightly accept its discovery. As he ascended back to the courtyard, the weight of history bore down upon him, every shadow seeming to watch his every move. With the mask secured, Luca emerged into the night, the moon still casting its ethereal glow over Venice. He knew he needed to conceal his discovery, to protect it from those who might misuse its power. His thoughts turned to the masquerade ball mentioned in one of the documents, a gathering of the city's elite, and a perfect place to blend in and plan his next move. Donning a simple but elegant mask, Luca made his way to the ball, held in a grand villa by the canal. The guests were all masked, the air alive with the sound of music and laughter, the gardens illuminated by hundreds of lanterns that flickered like stars come down to earth. Luca moved through the crowd, the golden mask now hidden beneath his cloak, his senses heightened to any sign of the custodians. As the night unfolded, Luca realized that the masquerade was more than just a social event. It was a meeting place for those who controlled the city from the shadows. Here, alliances were forged, and secrets exchanged behind the anonymity of masks. Luca listened and observed, gathering information that would help him understand the full extent of the mask's powers and the intentions of those who sought to control them. By the time the ball ended, Luca had made plans to meet with a key figure within the custodians, hoping to negotiate an understanding or alliance. As he left the villa, the golden mask securely hidden, he felt a mix of apprehension and excitement. The adventure was far from over. It had just entered a new, more dangerous phase.